Whoa! Hello, it's Jeff Leach here at Download Festival 2013 for Bloodstock Radio, the only radio station you ever need listen to. Joining me is the best dressed lady at the festival and one of the most charming, Lady Starlight. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm very well. We've already been chatting, so I feel like it's we've already had our conversation. Interview over, see you later. You're very very much a special guest here because you're going to be DJing at a secret party later on. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, it's top secret.
By the time this goes out, it'll be done, so we can reveal it. There's a certain band.
There is a band, and they have a few fans. They're a little bit underground, and you may not have heard of them, but... Geez, wait, let me think about their name. I think...
It's difficult to remember, isn't it? It's one of those forgettable...
words.
Something like steel. Steel. No, not steel.
Definitely something to do with metal.
Brass.
Brass.
Iron. Iron.
I feel like it's...
Tin?
Copper.
That's an alloy, so...
Copper.
It's Iron Maiden, isn't it? It's Iron Maiden.
I was trying to come up with something for Maiden, and it just didn't work very well.
Maiden makes me think of fantasy, you know, some sort, a little bit like you in your dress. So you're going to be DJing Iron Maiden's party tonight?
Yes.
Have you met the guys before?
I have, and they are genuinely...
Really old.
They are genuinely the nicest and most down-to-earth people I have ever met, and I love them so much I can't take it.
Would you suggest that maybe they're nicer than Dave Grohl is in rock and roll?
I've never met Dave Grohl.
He's apparently really, really nice.
I'd have to go with Iron Maiden.
See, so Dave, if you're listening, that's fighting words. Lady Starlight.
I love you, Dave, and I'm sure that you're very nice, but...
And you've done Download Festival before? Have you done Download Festival before?
I have.
Tell me a little bit how this one fares compared to previous years, because at least we've got brief bits of sunlight this year.
Yes. We just hit it perfectly right. I came in 2009 and 2000... What year is it now?
It's 2013, I think, all year.
So, 2011.
Yeah.
And I did the doghouse tent. And that
so you do it every couple of years?
Yeah, every... Well, the first time I was just a guest.
Okay.
So I just got drunk all the time. I didn't have to worry about...
I'm here in a professional capacity, and I'm getting drunk all the time anyway. I don't know why that would possibly stop you. And obviously...
Hot mess drunk.
Well, you're in like a quite an exciting time as well, because you're working on some music yourself, aren't you?
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that. When can we expect to hear some of those Lady Starlight tunes?
Ooh! Well, it's actually meant... It's more of a... experimental soundscape. It's very Brian Eno-esque.
Oh, she's so American. Go on. It's like a soundscape. You're going to be like making love to the music with your ears and your nose.
You're actually going to want to not listen to it at all.
When can we see this? When can we hear it? When can we hear your
when
see
can
your
you
music?
Be repulsed by my music. Well, I'm working on it now and working on a total website of like the entering the Lady Starlight brain.
Okay.
And again, you might want to do it, and you also might want to run away.
It'll be like a mindscape of music and fashion and art and culture, all from your brain.
Yes.
Direct to your website.
That.
Okay, yeah. So people should check that out, and that's where you're going to be able to find the music, the soundscape.
You do the interview for me. You just do the interview by yourself.
I'm just an interview by myself. How are you enjoying it, Lady Starlight? Like, my God, it's so amazing. I'm having a great time. You can interview me if you like. No one wants to hear about me.
What am I doing now?
Well, no, what I want to do is I want to ask you, obviously, about your relationship with one of the, if not the biggest star in the world, Lady Gaga.
Yeah. You may have heard of her, too.
You guys are really good friends.
We are.
You work together. Do you play golf together?
We don't. But we do ride bikes together.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that one of your pastimes, then? A little bit of cycling to keep the body and the mind fit?
Yeah. It's fun. I remember in Dallas, it's the only... Because she can keep moving. So, like, you know, because you're going, like, by, and people are like, is that... that couldn't be her.
Yeah.
So you can do, like, a drive-by.
Just your two fringes just speeding past. On bikes. On one gear fixies. And you've traveled around extensively around the entire globe with her. What,
yeah.
Was that a mind-blowing experience?
It is. I actually chose very much the wrong profession because I don't like traveling and I don't like being up late at night.
Okay.
Yeah. I definitely, that was like, dope.
So apart from the late nights that were annoying you.
Okay. No, besides from actual touring, I love being at shows and meeting and going to different places, but I just, we really have to work on that portal.
Start to one of those teleports in there, suddenly you're in Japan.
Yes.
Have you got any favorite countries? Because you've got fans all across the globe. I've looked at you, I added you on Twitter last night, and I saw you got like half a million or over half a million fans now. No, you're over half a million now, aren't you? About 600,000, I think.
No.
Oh, okay. Well, in my head, you are.
I mean, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm so famous.
She's got more than me. I got about 10,000, so I'm paling in insignificance compared to you. But do you have any countries?
Nothing exists except Twitter.
This is it. Oh, no, we're going to get rained on. We're going to ruin the hair. Have you got any particular countries that you have a soft spot for? I mean, this dress is from Japan, right?
It is. I love New Zealand.
Beautiful. My sister lives there.
I love it. And Australia, the best fans.
And also, if you've flown all that way.
Awesome, but I love. They just are so enthusiastic, but it is very far. And
it's
I did
not
24
hours flight from UK alone. So coming from the US, it's about 14 hours maybe.
It's closer. But it took me like 31 hours to get home in total. That is not appealing, I have to say.
Tell you what else isn't appealing is this weather.
About Australia is where how far it is from me.
I tell you what, I'm going to save your hair getting ruined because I know you want to look good for Iron Maiden later on. Lady Starlight, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you so much.
And good luck with the gig tonight. And when can we see you in London?
I'm going to be at the Metal Hammer Awards.
That's on Monday.
Ooh.
We're going to get inside. Go, go, go. Interview over. Thanks very much. Bye-bye. Bye.